Hey guys, this is Clinton Jeff, and today we're checking out the brand new Parley Adidas Ultra Boost DNA. If you've already watched my video on the Ultra 4D version of the shoe, things are pretty much the same here, except for the more comfortable midsole. But just in case you want to check out the Boost version, here you go. Let's check them out. What is kind of a throwback to the super limited Parley Adidas Ultra Boost prototype from 2015. In order to commemorate the 5th anniversary of Parley's first Ultra Boost, the Parley Adidas Ultra Boost DNA dropped on June 29th globally at a retail price of $220 in the US. They came in two colorways. There's a white version which is more similar to the 2015 version, but not exactly the same as you can see. And then there's this new black version which I think actually looks like the better of the two. Honestly, I should have bought the white version since I already have the Ultra 4D in the black version, but nope, here I am making wrong choices. Regardless, I don't know why they took 5 years to make this, but hey, at least it's finally here. In case you haven't heard about this partnership before, it's a collaboration between Adidas and Parley. Parley for the Oceans is a group that is freaking awesome because they collect ocean plastics to clean up the oceans and try to use that trash to create something more usable, way to be more sustainable. So what Adidas does is they work with Parley to take that plastic trash, break it down and spin it to create a yarn that they can use on their sneakers and clothing. Honestly, I just totally love this partnership. I love what Adidas and Parley are doing here. Coming to the shoe itself, the entire one-piece upper is covered in these thin greenish-blue zigzag stripes, which is actually a stitching detail similar to what has been used on every pair of Adidas Parley shoes so far. These stripes are made from yarn that is made out of Parley's signature recycled plastics, and they go from the toe box area all the way down to the heel. I love the way that the stripes rise and fall like waves in the ocean, especially around the midfoot area. I couldn't really find too much information on these, but it looks like the recycled plastics are only used in those stripes, and that's it. The black knit seems to be your standard Adidas prime knit material because it definitely feels just like standard prime knit. Moving on, slightly hidden under these green lines in a really subtle way is the Adidas 3 stripes on the midfoot area on both sides of the shoe. I love that you don't really see them unless the light hits it at the right angle. It's just so well done with a little bit of sheen to them as well. And then moving upwards, you have this really special lacing system. I say special because remember, this is a one-piece upper. So it's not a separate tongue here. Instead, it looks like that black knit material is actually a panel that the green stripes are stitched into. And this panel wraps around the entire upper of the shoe. So it's kind of a dual layer upper here. And you can see the edges of the panel embroidered into the upper. This black knit panel has these tiny lace loops which has the lacing system going through it, but the lace loops are kind of sandwiched between the dual layers. So yeah, it's pretty much your usual Ultra Boost upper here, but with this added layer on top. So while it does look really cool, it feels just like any other Ultra Boost upper when you're wearing these around. That being said, one thing about the flat black laces though is that they seem to be really long, which kind of spoils the look of the shoe in my opinion. So you're gonna have to be a little creative with how you lace these up to hide that. Apart from that, moving upwards, there's the Adidas 3 Stripes performance logo embroidered into the top of the tongue. And then coming to the inside of the shoe, you have the usual super comfortable Ultra Boost padded sock liner, which is in black. If you've ever worn a pair of Ultra Boost, you know how comfortable the plush padding is over here. And then there's the black insole with the Boost branding on the left side and the Adidas and Parley branding on the right side. Moving on, coming to the heel of the shoe, you'll see more of that green stitching that goes around to the back. It looks like there's an internal heel counter here or maybe just support inserts. But whatever it is, you do get a really good amount of support in the heel section here. Apart from that, there's the usual Ultra Boost upper pull tab kind of thing at the back. And that's about it. So yep, that same Ultra Boost upper but with this Parley edition. Moving downwards, that entire gorgeous upper sits on a full length Boost midsole. You guys probably already picked up on this by now, but I'm one of the biggest Ultra Boost fans out there. Boost is by far one of the most comfortable cushioning tech out there right now. And honestly, if you haven't tried out a pair of Ultra Boost by now, y'all are missing out. In fact, I definitely encourage you to head on over to an Adidas store and try out a pair of Ultra Boost just to know what I'm talking about. The only thing that comes close is Nike's React Foam, but Boost has been around for years now and Adidas has managed to achieve cushioning that is just the right amount of plush but reactive at the same time. This is why a lot of people think that Ultra Boost is by far the most comfortable shoe on the market. For years now, which make them great everyday wear lifestyle shoes. It just feels great underfoot with that bouncy feeling. And then moving downwards, you have the usual stretch web outsole with continental rubber for multi-surface traction and the usual torsion spring construction for support when the foot lands to propel your foot forward. That's about it for design. Coming to sizing and fit, I feel like these fit just like any other pair of Ultra Boosts, except for one major difference. They're definitely a bit more snug. It kind of feels closer to the sizing of the Ultra Boost 1.0s that had a more rigid knit. This is because the green stitching around the upper doesn't allow the prime knit to stretch out too much, so it's kind of a more rigid structure around the knit. It's not too bad or anything, it's just a little bit different and something that you should note in case you're used to wearing Ultra Boosts. So that being said, I will go true to size here if you have narrow feet, but if you have wide feet like I do, I would definitely recommend going up half a size or up even a full size. Like I usually wear UK 11 Ultra Boost, but I went up to UK 12 here just because I didn't want too snug a fit. In case you're worried about how these fit you, you can head on over to an Adidas store to try on the new Ultra Boost 20, which I think is a similar type of fit, just to give you an idea of how snug these are. But remember, the upper here isn't as stretchy as the one on the Ultra Boost 20. All right guys, with all of that out of the way, let's take a look at the Parley Adidas Ultra Boost DNA on feet. Honestly, I just think these are the best looking Ultra Boosts in a while. I totally love everything about this shoe, although I have to admit the Ultra 4D version does look a lot more aggressive. I really think I should have got the white colorway instead because that version looks more similar to the 2015 prototype. But that being said, the black colorway just generally looks better in my opinion. Alright guys, so that's what I think about the brand new Parley Adidas Ultra Boost DNA. I'm really interested to know what you guys think about these shoes and are you thinking about picking up a pair of these? Let me know right in the comment section below. Of course, if you want to see more photos of the Parley Ultra Boost DNA, you can check them out on my Instagram account and maybe give me a follow at Clinton Jeff. And hey, if you thought this video was helpful and you want to support the channel, don't forget to hit the like button right below and maybe subscribe because that would be massively appreciated. And yeah, that's about it. Thanks for watching guys and I'll catch you in the next one.